these coefficients belong to ring of complex numbers. So this polynomial is polynomial over C. So having said that, we define what a polynomial is. So far we have discussed examples of polynomials. So you must understand, then whenever we talk about polynomial, first of all we must have a ring in our mind, because a polynomial is defined over a ring, means that coefficients of a polynomial are going to be elements of a ring. So let's have the definition. Let R be a ring with identity. So let R be a ring with identity. Then an expression of the form let's say A naught plus A1x plus A2x square plus so on up to ANx raised to power n. We shall represent expression of this form by symbols F, G, H and so on. So this particular expression which we denote by F, and let's see what these coefficients are, where A naught, A1, A2, so on up to AN, these are elements of the ring. So these have to come from the ring. So this type of expression where coefficients are from the ring R is called a polynomial. And let's note this thing as well, that A naught, A1, A2, so on up to AN are called coefficients of the polynomial. So we note that. A naught, A1, A2, so on up to AN are called coefficients. So these are called coefficients. So having noted that, we come to the concept of addition and multiplication of polynomials. So addition and multiplication of polynomials. First of all, let's discuss when two polynomials are going to be equal. Let's have a note first, then we will come to addition and multiplication. So we note that. So suppose F and G are two polynomials over a ring R. So let R be a ring with identity. And F and G are polynomials over R. And let's write F and G. F is equal to A naught plus A one X plus A two X square plus so on up to A n x raised to power n, and g is equal to b naught plus b one x plus b two x square plus so on up to b n x raised to b m. N and m may be different, so let's write b m x raised to power m b polynomials over R. Let and this be polynomials. Over R. So when we say that these are polynomials over R, we mean that a naught, a one, a two, so on, and b naught, b one, b two, so on, belong to R. Then these two polynomials f and g are equal. F is equal to g if a naught is equal to b naught, a one is equal to b one, a two is equal to b two, and so on. And further, if m is less than n, and if m is less than n, what does this mean? We will come across this concept in more examples, so you will be understand these things when we will discuss few more things after this particular concept. And if m is less than n, then a m plus 1 is equal to 0, so on up to a n, all these are equal to 0. We will discuss few examples, then you will be able to understand what we mean about this here. So having defined when two polynomials are equal, if coefficients are equal, respectively coefficients are equal, so that's it. So now let's come to addition and multiplication of polynomials. Addition and multiplication of polynomials. So in order to understand this concept, let's consider few examples. So let's consider this example. So consider, in order to understand polynomials, it is easier to have coefficients from Z, the ring of integers. So this is the simplest ring, in fact, the ring of integers. And in order to understand what polynomials are, first it is better to understand polynomials over ring of integers, then you can discuss polynomials over any ring you like. So consider following polynomials over Z. So consider following polynomials over z. Over z means we are going to take coefficients from the ring of integers. So the polynomials we are going to consider are, let's say first polynomial is 5 plus 4x minus 3x square plus 7x cube plus 2x raised to power 4. And let's take the second polynomial, call it g, and this is 1 plus 6x plus 8x square, and that's it. I think in this case we have taken polynomial x up to x raised to power 4 and polynomial g up to x raised to power 2. So in this case m is less than n. This is what we have mentioned earlier. So these are the two polynomials then, and you know that how to add these two polynomials. Sum of these two polynomials is f plus g, and this you know this from your intermediate. 5 plus 1 is equal to 6, then 4 plus 6 is equal to 10 x minus 3 plus 8 is equal to 5 x square. Then there is no x cube here, so we simply write here 7x cube. There is no x raised to power 4 in g, so we write it 2x raised to power 4. So this is sum of these two polynomials f and g. So next we come to multiplication of these two polynomials. We multiply these two polynomials. I mean, we will multiply these two polynomials, f and g, with each other. So before coming to multiplication, let me produce these polynomials before you. So before coming to multiplication, let me reproduce the polynomials. Because it will be easier to understand if polynomials are before us. So polynomials are f is equal to 5 plus 4x minus 3x square. So 5 plus 4x minus 3x square plus 7x cube plus 2x raised to power 4. This is polynomial over ring of integers. And g is equal to 1 plus 6x plus 8x square. So we have to multiply these two polynomials with each other. And you know the process of multiplication. Then we multiply these two polynomials with each other. F multiplied with g is equal to, so please note that you know how to multiply these polynomials with each other. You know that first you will take 5 and multiply with all these, then you multiply 4x with all these, and then minus 3x squared, then plus 7x, then plus 2x raised to power 4. Then you will add the like terms which have same power of x with each other. You will add their coefficients, and so this is what the result I hope you are going to get. So f into g is equal to 5 plus 34x plus 61x squared plus 21x cube. You can do it by yourself. And then plus 20x raised to power 4. and then plus 68 x raised to power 5, and then plus 16 x raised to power 6. This is fine. In fact, you are going to get 8x square multiplied with 2x raised to power 4 will be equal to 8 into 2 is 16. X square multiplied with x raised to power 4 is equal to x raised to power 6. So this is f multiplied with g, product of these two polynomials. So I simply wanted to demonstrate how we add polynomials, how we multiply polynomials, and you know all these things already from your previous knowledge. So now we come to notation. So in fact, we are going to discuss the notation, how we represent the set of polynomials over a ring. So let R be a ring with identity. Let R be a ring with identity. Then we write the set of all polynomials over R. Then we write the set of all polynomials over this particular ring R as R. We denote was the better word here. Then we denote the set of all polynomials over R as, but anyway, then we write is okay. So then we write the set of all polynomials over R as follows. So this is a set of all polynomials over R. Over R means the coefficients are from the ring R. So this is f is a polynomial such that f is a polynomial so f is a polynomial over R, mean coefficients of f are from the ring R. So this is comparatively simpler phrase to say that f is a polynomial over R. So this set of all the polynomials with coefficients from the ring R, we represent this particular set by this symbol. We write R and then we put this particular bracket and write X in between the bracket. So Rx means the set of all polynomials over ring R. So having said that, or having designed or devised our notation, we come to a proposition. So proposition says that let R be a ring with identity. Let R be a ring with identity. Then Rx, and we have defined above what Rx is. Then Rx, that is the set of all polynomials over R, or the set of all polynomials with coefficients from R, it is same thing. let me write with coefficient so that you may become used to other phrase as well. So set up all polynomials with coefficients from R over R, it is same thing, with coefficients from R is a ring with identity. So we have to prove that. So let's come to proof. So we have to prove that this particular set is a ring, and this is a ring with identity. And you know that in order to show that this is a ring, we have to define two binary operations, addition and multiplication. And we will show that under addition, this is an abelian group. Under multiplication, it is closed. Multiplication is associative. And then multiplication is distributive over addition. And there is an identity polynomial. So these are things we have to do. So for proof, let's first note that we have, let's have R x before us. So we have R x is equal to, this is set of all the polynomials f such that f is a polynomial over R. So this is what R x is. Having defined that, we come to binary operations addition and multiplication term by term. So first of all, we come to addition. So we shall prove that Rx is an abelian group under addition. So we shall prove that Rx is abelian group under addition. So in order to prove that, first we have to define addition. So for that purpose, let's define the addition. So in order to define addition, we need two polynomials. So let's take two polynomials from Rx. So let fg belong to Rx. So where f is equal to a naught plus a1x plus a2x square plus so on up to an x raised to power n. And let's take the second polynomial, that is g, and this is equal to b naught plus b1x plus b2x square and then plus so on up to, let's use m for polynomial g, bm x raised to power m. And when we discussed examples, you might have noted that it is not necessary that m and n are equal. So it may be that one of them is smaller than other. So if there is possibility of being smaller, so let's take m is smaller than n, or maybe both are equal. So if anyone is smaller, that is going to be m, which we have written later, or they both are equal. So anyone of them may be smaller, but we have chosen second one to be smaller. So it does not affect generality. So in general, it is okay saying that. Then, this is the way we are going to define addition of these two polynomials. So note that very carefully. We define f plus g is equal to, so that's very simple, a naught plus b naught. So we add the constant terms with each other, a naught plus b naught, and then plus a1x plus b1x. So we add them with each other and take x common. So this is equal to a1 plus b1, and we take x common. Same thing we do with these two, we take x square common. So this is a2 plus b2, and x square is common. And then plus, so on. And we keep on doing that until we reach this particular step, and that is am plus bm, am plus bm, and we take x raised to power m common. Note that we have said that if some one from m and n is smaller, then m is smaller than n. So am is going to somewhere before an, and that is going to be added with bm x raised to power m. We take x raised to power m common, and then plus, so on up to, then after bm, we do not have any bm after that, so we will be left with only an. So at the end we are going to get an x raised to power n, and you can check it by designing an example on your own, and we have discussed an example before. You can check from that particular example. So this is the way we have defined sum of these two polynomials. Very simple thing, a naught plus b naught, a1 plus b1, a2 plus b2, am plus bm. There will be am somewhere here, and so on. So this is sum of these two polynomials. So we have defined sum of the polynomials, and note that sum of these two polynomials is a polynomial again. So if f belongs to Rx and g belongs to Rx, then f plus g also belongs to Rx. Therefore, Rx is closed under the addition we have defined. So we know that f plus g is also a polynomial with coefficients from R. So f plus g belongs to Rx. So we have defined addition, and we have noted that Rx is closed under the addition we have defined. Therefore, Rx is closed under addition. So this was our first step. We have established that sum of two polynomials over R is again a polynomial over R. So having done that, let's come to associativity of addition. Secondly, associativity of addition. So for associativity, we know that we have to take three elements or three polynomials. So let f, g, and let's say h for third polynomial. So let f, g, h belong to Rx, the set of polynomials with coefficients from the ring R. Then, now note that as far as associativity is concerned, it is going to be inherited from associativity of addition in the ring R. So we are simply going to observe that if these are three polynomials, then if we add f polynomial with g polynomial and add h polynomial later with some of these two, or we add g polynomial with h polynomial and add the f polynomial after from left hand side, then these two are going to be equal. And the reason we are going to give is that because addition is associative in the ring R, because addition is associative in the ring R. In fact, when you add two polynomials, what you are doing is you are doing addition of the elements of the ring. In order to add these two polynomials, you add a naught plus b naught, which are elements of the ring. You add a1 with b1, a1 plus b1. a1, b1 are elements of the ring. So when you add polynomials, addition you are going to work with is addition of the ring R. So since addition of the ring R is associative, so associativity of addition of ring R will be induced on addition of the polynomials. So since addition is associative in the ring R, so addition of polynomials will be associative as well. So this is sufficient to write this thing. There's associative law will hold because addition is associative in the ring R. So having done that, let's come to additive identity. So additive identity. So as far as additive identity is concerned, is very simple. Just take the zero polynomial. So the polynomial in fact we are going to consider this polynomial a naught plus a1 x plus a2 x square plus so on up to, let's say, a n x raised to power n. And then we are going to impose the condition that a naught, a1, a2, a n, all these coefficients are equal to 0. Each of these coefficients is equal to 0. So where a naught is same as a1, a1 is same as a2, and a2 is same as an, and each one of these is equal to 0. So in fact this polynomial is 0 plus 0x plus 0x square plus so on up to 0x raised to power n. So a0, a1, a2, so on up to an, each one of these is 0. So we denote this polynomial by capital O to show that this is 0. So the polynomial, this particular polynomial in which each coefficient is equal to 0, is additive identity in Rx, is additive identity in this particular set Rx, and reason is because if you add any polynomial with this particular polynomial, f plus this particular polynomial, zero polynomial, or zero polynomial plus f will be equal to f for any polynomial f belonging to Rx. And you can see it very easily because each one of a naught, a1, a2, so on up to an is zero. So additive identity is there. Having said that, we come to additive inverses. Additive inverses. So for additive inverses, let's take a polynomial f. Let f be a polynomial over R, or f belongs to Rx. And let's see what f is, where f is equal to a0 plus a1x plus a2x square plus so on up to anx raised to power n. So it simply means that a naught, a1, a2, so on up to an are elements of the ring R. So let's take this particular polynomial then. Then we can define a very special polynomial. Let we denote it by minus f. This belongs to this set of polynomial Rx. And what this is going to be? All we are going to do is that we are going to change signs of coefficients of the polynomial f. A naught, we write it minus a naught. A1x, we write it minus a1x. Minus a2x square, and then minus so on up to minus anx raised to power n. So given a polynomial f, we can define a very special polynomial denoted by minus f. So if f is a polynomial, then we have minus f polynomial belonging to Rx as this, such that, and you can see it very easily now, that if we add f with minus f, f plus minus f, and you can see that a plus minus a will become 0, a1 minus a1 will become 0, a2 minus a2 will become 0, so on up to an minus an will become 0, so their sum will be 0 polynomial. Similarly, if you add minus f with f, minus f plus f, this will be minus a naught plus a naught 0, minus a1 plus a1 0, so this will be equal to 0 polynomial. So given a polynomial, you simply change the signs of the coefficients. Therefore, minus f is additive inverse of f in the set Rx. Therefore, minus f is additive inverse of f in the set of polynomials Rx. So this is about additive inverse. So finally, we have to check. So let's stop at this particular point and note that therefore Rx is a group under addition. Next, we have to show that this is commutative or abelian group. So let's observe that or conclude that at this particular step that therefore Rx is group under addition. Because we have defined addition, we have shown that Rx is closed under addition, we have showed that addition is associative in Rx, then we have established that additive identity is there, then we have established that additive inverses are there, therefore Rx is group under addition. So only thing we have to show now about addition is that Rx is an abelian group. So we have to establish the commutativity. So for commutativity, let's take two polynomials f and g which belong to the set Rx, that is set of polynomials with coefficients from the ring R. Let's see what f and g we are going to take. So where f is equal to a naught plus a1x plus a2x square plus so on up to anx raised to power n and g is equal to b naught plus b1x plus b2x square plus so on up to bmx raised to power m. Note that this is a step to be written very carefully because it is not necessary that if you take two polynomials, both polynomials will contain same number of terms. One polynomial may contain more terms, other may contain less terms. So we have to be very careful about that. In this case, we are going to note that number of terms in G may be less than or may be equal to number of terms in F. So this is the possibility. So anyway, if these are two polynomials, then their sum F plus G. We know that this is going to be the way we have defined it, a naught plus b naught plus a1 plus b1 multiplied with x, we take x common in fact, plus a2 plus b2 and we take x square common and then plus so on up to, since we have taken m is less than n, so we will have am plus bm am plus bm x raised to power m and then plus so on up to at the end we will have an x raised to power n plus an x raised to power n. So this is the sum of these two polynomials f and g, and this is equal to, you can write a naught plus b naught as b naught plus a naught because these are elements of the ring and addition in the ring is commutative, so you can write it like this, and then b1 plus a1 x common, then b2 plus a2, because addition is commutative in the ring, x square, and then plus 1 up to bm plus am, and x raised to power m common, and then plus 1 up to an x raised to power n will remain as it is. And you can see that if this is f plus g, this is g plus f, and this is equal to g plus f. So therefore addition is commutative in Rx. Therefore addition is commutative in Rx. And therefore Rx is an abelian group under addition. Now, so under multiplication we have to show that multiplication is defined and Rx is closed. Under the multiplication we will define, and then multiplication is associative, and then we will come to distributivity of multiplication over addition. So for multiplication, so we take two polynomials. So let f and g belong to Rx. The set of polynomials with coefficients from the ring R. So let f and g belong to Rx, where let's see what f and g are. So where f is equal to a0 plus a1x plus a2x square plus 1 up to an x raised to power n, and g is equal to b0 plus b1x plus b2x square plus 1 up to bm x raised to power m, or maybe m is less than n and maybe they are equal, but if one of them is smaller, that is m, this is what we have chosen. Then we define multiplication of these two polynomials as follows. Multiplication of these polynomials, f and g, f multiplied with g is equal to, so you have to be very careful in order to understand what we are going to say. So what we are going to do is that we are going to multiply a0 with b0. So constant a0 multiplied with constant b0. So having done that, next we are going to identify those terms which contain x raised to power 1. Those terms which contain x, and we are going to take x common from those terms, and note that when we multiply a0 with b1x, it will be a0 b1x, and when we multiply a1x with b0, it will be a1 b0x, and we take x common from these two. There will be no other term involving x raised to power 1 except these two terms. So we take x common, So it will be a naught b1 plus a1 b naught, a1 b naught, a1 b naught, and then x common, and then plus. Now we are going to identify those terms which involve x square, or second exponent of x, x square, second power of x. And we are going to take x square common from those terms, and those terms are going to be, when we multiply a naught with b2 x square, so it will be a naught b2 and x square common. So a naught b2. And then plus. Next we will multiply a1x with b1x. This will be a1 b1 x square. So x square common. So this is a1 b1. And then next we will multiply a2 x square with b0. So it will become a2 b0 x square. Multiplying these two with each other, then when you multiply. So this will be a2 b0 and x square common. So it makes very beautiful symmetry. In fact, let me explain that. We have a0 b0, then a0 b1, a1 b0, a0 b2, a1 b1, a2 b0, b0. It is easier to see it here. Note that this subscript of a naught keeps on increasing. A0, a1, what I should say, subscript of a keeps on increasing. So a0, a1, a2, and subscript of b keeps on decreasing. B2, B1, B0. So with this experience, let's write the next term with symmetry I have explained. So next will be A naught. We will have to take X cube common. So A naught B3, B3 X cube will be here. And a3 x cube will be here. So a naught b3. So having written a naught or a0 b3, you know that the next term is going to be a1 b2. Subscript of a will keep on increasing and of b will keep on decreasing. And next it is going to be, it is a1, it will be a2. And this is b2, this is going to be b1, it will decrease. And next, it is a2, it is going to be a3 now, it is going to increase. And this is b1, this is going to b0 or b0. And at reaching at b0 or b0, we will stop and we take x cube common. And then so on, you, if you like, you can write the term involving x raised to power 4 and so on, and at the end we will arrive at a n b m x raised to power n plus m, a n b m x raised to power n plus m, because you know that exponents add when we multiply. So x raised to power n multiplied with x raised to power m will be x raised to power n plus m, and then an and bm coefficients multiplied with each other. So multiplication of these two polynomials, this is the result. And we note that this is element of the ring, element of the ring, element of the ring, element of the ring. So this is a polynomial with coefficients from the ring R. So we note that the product we have defined f multiplied with g, this belongs to Rx. So therefore Rx is closed under multiplication. Therefore the set of polynomials with coefficients from the ring R is closed under multiplication. So we have defined multiplication and we have proved that under the multiplication we have defined set, the set Rx is closed. So having done that, next we have to establish that this multiplication is associative. So let's come to associativity of multiplication now. So for associativity, we have to take three polynomials and we are simply going to remark that since multiplication is associative in the ring R, therefore it is going to be associative in the set Rx as well, because when we multiply two polynomials, in fact we multiply the coefficients and those coefficients are elements of the ring. So since multiplication in the ring is associative and multiplication of the polynomials depends upon multiplication of the elements of the ring R, therefore multiplication of the polynomials is going to be associative as well. So it is sufficient to observe this particular thing. And so let's do that. So let FGH be three polynomials. So let FGH belong to Rx, the set of polynomials with coefficients from the ring X. Then all we have to observe is that if we multiply G polynomial with H and then we multiply with F from the left hand side, R, we multiply F with G and we multiply with H from the right hand side, then these two are going to be equal, which is inherited from associativity of associativity of multiplication in the ring R, and therefore multiplication of polynomials is associated. Therefore multiplication of polynomials is associative. So having said that, next we come to distributivity. So let's come to distributive laws. And about distributive, we are simply going to comment the same thing as we have done for associativity, since multiplication is distributive over addition in the ring R, and addition and multiplication of polynomials depends upon addition and multiplication of ring R. Since multiplication is distributive over addition in the ring R, therefore multiplication of polynomials will be distributive over addition of polynomials in the set R X as well. So that is sufficient to note and say. So let f, g, h belong to R X. Belong to the ring R X. Then if we add G with H and multiply it with F from the left hand side, result will be equal to F G plus F H. And similarly, if we multiply F with G plus H from the right hand side, this will be equal to GF plus HF. That is, multiplication will distribute over addition from left as well as right. So, which is again inherited from distributivity of addition over multiplication in R, which is also inherited from distributivity of multiplication over addition in the ring R. So distributivity is there, therefore Rx is a ring. So these were the conditions which conclude that Rx is a ring. And our proposition said that we have to prove that Rx is a ring with identity. We have to establish that identity element is there. So let's discuss that. So for identity, so consider this particular polynomial. We denote this polynomial by capital I. We are going to prove that this is identity. So consider capital I belong to Rx, where we explain what I is. I is a polynomial, so this is going to be of this particular form, a naught plus a1x plus a2x square plus so on up to anx raised to power n. And we are going to define what these coefficients are, and this is the way we are going to do that. We are going to say that a naught is equal to 1. 1 is a multiplicative identity in the ring R. And all others, a1, a2, so on up to an, all of these are 0. So just note that what will happen. This is 1 and all the other are 0. So if all the other are 0, everything will become 0 except 1 at this particular place. So I will be 0 plus 1. Sorry, I will be 1 plus 0 plus 0 plus 1 up to 0. So this will be equal to 1. So this is the way we define I. Then we can easily see that if we multiply I with any polynomial f, or we multiply a polynomial f with I, these results will be equal and this will be equal to f. It is very simple to see that because I is nothing except I is 1. Remember that I is 1. You can see it very easily. Then this is equal to f. Let me explain that, because I is just 1, I is equal to 1 plus 0. So I multiplied with f is equal to f multiplied with I is equal to f, and this is going to happen for all f belonging to Rx, and therefore this particular polynomial is multiplicative identity in Rx. So therefore the particular polynomial we have defined in this way is multiplicative identity in Rx, and therefore Rx is a ring with identity. Therefore, Rx, ring of polynomials with coefficients from the ring R, is ring with identity. So this completes the proof. So having completed the proof that, let's note what we have proved. We have proved that if we are given a ring R with identity, then the set of all polynomials with coefficients from the ring R is itself a ring with identity. So having proved that, let's note that If the ring R is commutative, then the ring of polynomials is commutative as well. So if R is commutative, then Rx is commutative as well. So let's have another note that let's take two polynomials from the ring R. Let FG belong to ring RX. And let's see what these polynomials are. We just choose, we are doing as per routine. where f is equal to a naught plus a1 x plus a2 x square plus 1 up to a n x raised to power n, and g is equal to b naught plus b1 x plus b2 x square plus so on up to bm x raised to power m. So let's take these two polynomials. Then if m and n are equal, we have then if the polynomial f is equal to polynomial g, in fact what we must do is that we must take m and n equal, and then if in fact the condition I was going to make is that I want to make these polynomials consisting of constants only. So f is equal to just a naught and g is equal to just b naught. So for that purpose, let's take m is equal to n is equal to 0. So if we take m and n 0, then the polynomial f will be a naught only, and the polynomial g will be b naught only. So f is equal to just a naught and g is equal to just b naught, and in this case if we add these two polynomials f and g, this will be equal to a naught plus b naught. And if we multiply these two polynomials, f and g, this will be equal to a naught multiplied with b naught. In fact, what we want to comment is that the polynomials f is equal to a naught and g is equal to b naught are in fact constant polynomials, and their addition and multiplication is just the addition and multiplication as we do in the ring R. So the polynomials f is equal to a naught and g is equal to b naught are called constant polynomials. Are called constant polynomials, and their addition and multiplication is just the addition and multiplication of ring R. Let me explain it to you. With the help of a particular example. The simplest example of a ring, I think, is R is equal to Z, the ring of integers. You know that this is minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. So this is the simplest example of ring. So let's take ring as ring of integers and consider Rx, the ring of polynomials. The ring of polynomials over R, which is in fact equal to Z. Then the constant polynomials in Rx, then the constant polynomials in Rx will be of the form suppose we take a polynomial f and this is a constant polynomial, then this polynomial f may be equal to say 3, and suppose we take a polynomial say g and this polynomial may be equal to say 8. So 3 is a constant polynomial, 8 is a constant polynomial, f we name it as 3, g we name it as 8, and note that sum of these two polynomials f plus g is equal to 3 plus 8 and this is equal to 11, and product of these two polynomials f into g is equal to 3 into 8 and this is equal to 24. So what we have said above is that if we are given constant polynomials, then their addition and multiplication behaves as addition or multiplication in the ring or in the ring R, in fact. So these are the let me explain a little bit more. The constant polynomial f is equal to 3 is in fact equal to 3 plus 0x1 plus 0x2, sorry, 0x raised to power 1 plus 0x square plus 0x cube, so on up to 0x raised to power n. And the polynomial g will be equal to 8 plus 0x raised to power 1 plus 0x raised to power 2 plus so on up to 0x raised to power m. So this is in fact what we were saying here at this particular place. M is equal to n is equal to 0, saying this particular thing will make all these things 0, and all we are left with is the constant terms 3 and 8. So one thing more, we will be mostly concerned with non-zero constant polynomials. So we will be first discussing the case where constant polynomials are non-zero. In fact, just zero is also a polynomial, because when we proved that Rx is a ring, then zero polynomial was additive identity. So zero itself is a constant polynomial, but we will discuss the zero polynomial a bit later, and before we will be concentrating on those constant polynomials which are non-zero polynomials. It has in fact certain reason, so it will be clear soon as we progress. So this was about constant polynomials. We can take few examples. So constant polynomials over or the ring of real numbers are examples of constant polynomials, constant non-zero polynomials. Non-zero polynomials. Over or the ring of real numbers. The ring of real numbers. Or we may take as we may take f is equal to we have taken 3 before, so we may take f is equal to 3, this is a constant polynomial. We may take g is equal to, we have taken 8 before, so g is equal to 8, this is constant polynomial. And we may take polynomial h, it is constant polynomial, maybe 1 upon 2. And if you like, we may take constant polynomial, let's say k, this is equal to square root of let's say 8, and so on. So these are constant polynomials in ring of polynomials with coefficients from the ring of real numbers, so and so on. So just to give you a few examples of constant polynomials. So having said that, we come to a concept which is about degree of a polynomial. So now this will be our fifth section. So degree of a polynomial. So this is a very important concept and needs a little bit more attention. So consider few polynomials over z. I think this is the best and simplest ring to understand things. So we take polynomials over ring z, the ring of integers. So consider following polynomials over z. Consider following polynomials over z. Over z mean coefficients will be integers, and to have integral coefficients makes things much more simpler. So first polynomial we take f. We have taken this polynomial already in the beginning when we were discussing polynomials. So f, we wrote this polynomial as 5 plus same for polynomial we started with. I have taken same as example because it will be simpler to make you understand these things. So f 5 plus 4x minus 3x square plus 7x cube and then plus 2x raised to power 4. We discussed this polynomial in the beginning and we considered polynomial g as well, which was 1 plus 6x plus 8x square. So we have these two polynomials we have already discussed, and these are polynomials over ring of integers. We may write these polynomials as we may write this polynomial f as 2x raised to power 4 plus 7x cube minus 3x square plus 4x and then plus 5. The same polynomial, we have simply rearranged the terms in slightly different way, and similarly we can write this polynomial g as 8x square plus 6x plus 1. So we can write these two polynomials f and g as this. So informally speaking, this is not a formal definition. In fact, I am simply trying to explain a concept in an informal way. So informally speaking, four is degree of f and degree of g is equal to 2. So let me say it, the exponent of the highest power in a polynomial is called degree of the polynomial informally. So the highest power in the polynomial x is in the polynomial f is x raised to power 4. This is the highest power of x, and exponent of this highest power is 4. So degree of this polynomial f is 4. Similarly, highest power of x in this polynomial g is x square, and exponent of x square is 2. So degree of polynomial g is 2. This is informal way of saying things. So let me write it. Informally speaking, degree of f we write it as deg, deg for degree and then f. Degree of f is equal to 4. And degree of g is equal to, we write it deg, degree of g is equal to 2. So degree of f is equal to 4 and degree of g is equal to 2. So these are the polynomial we have already discussed, and we have seen earlier that we added these two polynomials, and I'm going to write their sum and their product. So we have seen earlier that sum of these two polynomials f and g, you can go back and verify that we have discussed this already. So f plus g is equal to 2x raised to power 4, f plus g, 2x raised to power 4 plus 7x cube and then plus 8x square minus 3x square, 5x square, and then plus 10x 10x, 4x plus 6x is 10x, and then plus 5 plus 1 is equal to 6, the sum of these two polynomials. And product of these two polynomials, you can check it on yourself, and we have done it before, and that is 16x raised to power 6, and then plus 68x raised to power 5, and then plus 20x raised to power 4, and then plus 21x raised to power 3, 21x cube, and then plus 61x square, and then plus 34x, and then plus 5. Please check this multiplication. I might have made some mistake, but please check it on yourself. Anyway, so multiplying these two polynomials with each other, you can do it very easily. Multiply these two with each other. This is the result hopefully we get. So the sum of these two polynomials, and this is product of these two polynomials.